there, young ladies. I've just about enough of this screeching music.
Mother, we're watching the 40 Colin show.
Penny, your mother called all frantic. She said you were punished.
I'm always punished.
And Tracy, I have told you about that hair. All ratted up like a teenage Jezebel.
Oh, Mother, you're so 50s.
That, of course, was some John Waters 1988 film Hairspray. From Pink Flamingos to Cecil B. Demented to his new book, Role Models, John Waters has brought cult classics into the mainstream, much to the delight and horror of millions. The fabulous John Waters joins me now. Hey, John.
Hello.
Now, you know, I was reading the book, yeah. And one of your favorite role models, mm-hmm. is a member of the Manson family, Leslie Van Houten.
Well, it's Van Halen. If we're going to talk about it, be Van serious, because it's the only chapter in the book that is very serious.
I know. No.
There's no jokes in that chapter.
No,
the
no
rest
jokes.
Of the book is humorous. This is a terrible
I know, but
situation.
I'm yeah. starting only with that because okay. what is your interest in, why do you care about her?
I care about her because I was very drawn to the crime from the very beginning. It sort of ended the 60s. We made movies at the time to scare hippies, and unfortunately they did in real life, and uh-huh. it ended everything.
Did you miss me? I missed you. I got really sick again and had to go back to the hospital. I had a big operation and found out I have this gnarly autoimmune disease called sarcoidosis, but it's treatable with drugs, so I think I'm on the mend. It will take a long time, though. The good news, it seems that Bob has given me the gift of an excuse to repent, quit my job, and slack off. Yes! The dollars and cents will have to wait until the debt ceiling is busted out so I can find out if I've successfully weaseled my way into the government coffers. In the meantime, I've busted out of this meat body, shed about 50 pounds of it, actually, and I'm ridding myself of this mediocrity in disguise and getting a proper subgenius hairstyle back as befits my natural state. I have no need to make anyone think I'm one of them anymore, so I don't have to act stupid, at least not for several months. While this pink disease is being sickened and festered by the mystical workings of the natural sciences, I raise my slack flag anew. Now, many people in my life have attempted to Google this sarcoidosis, and some more reactionary souls have become extremely alarmed by it. My doctor warned me of this and said whatever I read has probably very little to do with my particular condition. But this is what I expect him to say because this is what he wants me to think. So it's probably true. Whatever the internet says is happening to my body, which would cause any reasonable person to open his PayPal account and send donations to Alley@hellboundalley.com, three E's, to alleviate the tens of thousands of dollars in debt in which I find myself. $1,600 here, $1,400 there. It's adding up fast. Or not. It's not like I'm giving that much of myself to you guys these days. It really is all I can do to plan this hair thing. But I am thinking about some kind of two-tone red and black thing. What do you think? Something hate-inspiring? Something more hellbound?
Thank you. From PR News in Washington, I'm now in retirement after some 50 years in service. The government says investigators remained in a Chicago street. On Wall Street, 3-10-7-7-10-2-2-6. Kidnappers in Iraq, including an American, pledged to repair New Orleans Katrina evacuees. Former President Bill Clinton says Al Gore would damage the U.S. economy.
But he also comes with some former girlfriend of his who reportedly won hundreds of thousands of dollars with his help.
The Bush administration rejects PR News.
Father of Abraham, really Lazarus, come.
Lord, dip your finger in the water and cool my fortune. Lord, dip your finger in the water and cool my fortune. Lord, dip your finger in the water and cool my fortune. Come, but I'm done. Lord, dip your finger in the water and cool my fortune.
I look back on it and I feel bad. I dedicated one of my movies to them in the beginning in sort of a punk rock smart-ass attitude, Pink Flamingos.
Yeah.
And after teaching in prison and visiting Leslie for 25 years in jail, I'm very serious believing that she deserves to be paroled. Now, I understand that in this chapter I bring up every negative and very realistic thing the victim's family said against her parole, which I think I have to.
Right.
And I would never criticize what they say. But Leslie met a madman when she was 17 years old. And I believe in rehabilitation. I believe that she has become the person she would have become if she never met him. And she doesn't even blame the drugs or him. She said, it's my fault to make him a leader. A leader can't be a cult leader.
Well, I mean, she did have, he was a Svengali and he was the evil incarnate.
And she was 17.
But she was 17.
She should have gone to jail.
But she did kill that LaBianca woman. She stabbed her 16 times. Yes. And, you know, what if she already dodged a bullet because they got rid of the death penalty?
I'll argue that point. Her second trial, she had a hung jury.
Thank you. Well, I'm getting mighty tired seeing hippies running wild and burning down the school, stepping on the flag. Things are getting out of hand when you read about a man that'll burn his draft card, hang around the pool room and brag. Some folks think it's okay, but I wasn't raised that way, and I won't be satisfied till I've had my say. It's America, you got no right to deceive it.
It's the best there is.
You'd better believe it.
Good men gave their lives
so we could live to see it. It's America, love it or leave it. Things are going mighty wrong when respect for law is gone, and it seems that everybody hates a uniform. Kinda hard to understand when you read about a man that's talking about love, knocking the place he was born. If things don't go their way, they can always move away. That's what democracy means anyway. It's America, you got no right to deceive it.
It's the best there is.
And you better believe it.
Good men gave their lives
so we could live to see it. It's America, love it or leave it. It's America, love it or leave it.
The first trial, it was taken away. She got the death penalty. Second trial, hung jury. Because some thought, wanted to let her go for diminished capacity. Not let her go, but a much lesser crime.
Yeah.
The third crime, convicted. You can't use either of the first.
Fun, which is right. Little Richard. You talk about Little Richard. I must hear some. I mean, people don't realize that he was basically the pioneer of rock and roll.
Well, Elvis came first, but he scared all white people and black people. That was what he did. He scared every race.
Yeah.
And you look at him now and you think, what the hell was that? Thank you.
NPR News in Washington. I'm Blamed on the Storm. Police officers in California's Central Valley are questioning reports that 2 7-year-old girls dressed in bow ties have reduced gang activity. 2 7-year-old girls were shut down from Northern Virginia to Maine. Police in Western Japan say a 12-year-old girl crashed into their bedroom. It was a third schoolgirl in less than a month. Investigators say 2 7-year-old girls have killed hundreds of people. Oakland authorities say investigators say 2 12-year-old girls agreed to start formal talks on ways to fight PR News from Washington. Police in Western Japan say 2 7-year-old girls dressed in suits and bow ties are vandalizing Montreal. Bob reports.
A spokesman for the Stockton Police Department says Bob is still involved in criminal activity in the region. Time, Bob.
National Transportation Safety Board member Ellen Engelman Connors ended up on a city street.
Police officers dressed in bow ties had been killed in separate incidents as they walked home from elementary school. The killings have unnerved PR News in Washington.
And, you know, that's why his song, The Girl Can't Help It, was Jane Mansfield's song originally, and then we turned it into Divine's theme song.
Uh-huh.
Little Richard was great. He invented rock and roll. He was the first one. I stole his mustache. I still wear it.
That mustache is not a real mustache.
Yes, it is. Touch it. Don't smear it.
It's a pencil.
No, it isn't. It's totally, it's a little pencil.
There's fur there? There's fuzz?
There's more than fuzz. I shave it and cut it.
So you shave the mustache off?
You shave it here and clip it here and then draw it in a little bit with Maybelline Velvet Black, the only kind that works.
And you You're an expert.
And you have to sharpen it every time.
And you stole that from Little Richard?
Yeah, he has it. His looked like he put it on with an industrial magic marker these days. But still, yeah, he had it first. Yeah.
He was very outspoken, too.
He was.
He would just say whatever he felt like saying.
He used to say things like, my hair was hanging down everywhere. I mean, he has great stuff. But then I went to interview him, and we had trouble because I brought up some of the great things that he said in his book about having threesomes with Buddy Holly and great women. And he got nervous. And I said, well, you wrote it.
Thank you. Italian melodies. Ma sole mio guaglio, non ha caprese carozzo. Do you believe in Napoli? Tu mi prima celentano, king of rock Italiano. Do you believe in me, Italy? Yeah.
I'm covering it for Playboy magazine.
Yeah. Threesomes with Buddy Holly?
Yeah, great for him.
Wow, I didn't...
That's in his book. I'm not telling any dirt. I'm asking him about it. It was in his book.
But it was also out at the time,
well,
right?
If you call that out, out into what? What is the
I mean, we're
Richard?
Talking about the
God
50s
knows.
Now.
I mean, it seemed like he said, recently he said the bakery has a lot in it, but the bakery's been closed for a long time. I'm not sure what Little Richard does today. It's not my business.
No, but at that time, he was kind of out as a gay guy,
wasn't
he?
Said women, men, dogs, cats, everybody came, groups. He said people threw their bras, their drawers, their panties, everything on stage to him. He was first. Before they were throwing their panties to Tom Jones, they were throwing them to Little Richard.
Really?
Yeah.
But I mean, if you say you're everything, then you're nothing, really. So you sort of like get out of it in a certain way.
Well, I think in the 50s, it was tough. You know, if you were Little Richard, it probably wasn't so easy to deal with sexuality in any ways because people were frightened of him. They saw him and ran, you know, no matter what he was into. But he said to me in the interview, I invented it. I don't know what he invented, but he...
What did he invent?
But
what
I believe
what
it.
What does he think he
You know,
invented?
Sometimes it was like when I was young, nobody asked me if you were gay or straight because they were afraid it was something worse.
PR News in Washington. I'm erupted in Sydney. A federal judge in Houston killed former Lebanese Prime Minister Rafiq Williams. A federal appeals court violates the Constitution. Two nursing home patients attacked people who appear to be of Middle Eastern descent. Barring intervention from the governor, this is PR News. PR's bad.
PR's bad. The nigger says otherwise.
Checking stocks 44107998264. The NASDAQ Composite Index is scheduled to be executed just after PR News in Washington.
Time to dance, yeah! It's so much fun being up on our feet.
They didn't want to know.
They didn't want to know.
Yeah, they didn't want to know.
So what do you answer now when someone asks you?
Oh, I say I'm gay, but I always think in the press when they say openly gay, what's that mean? Do they say, like, openly heterosexual Tom Cruise was here tonight?
What do you think of the fact that Elton John is performing for Rush Limbaugh's...
I think it's hilarious.
Wedding.
Because it forces the issue. I think it's great. It's gaily incorrect, and at the same time, it's anarchy. I think it's wonderful.
And it's $1 million
in his
pocket.
It's great. Good for him. He got some money. He'll spend it the right way. He'll spend it. I think it's great, Elton.
So you don't think the gay community is going to be critical of...
They are. The gay community sometimes is humor impaired. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not gaily correct either. I don't fit in there. They were against this movie, Tranny Killers or something. I thought, oh, come on.
They don't like the word tranny.
We got bigger enemies than trannies. They said the transvestites acted like drag queens. Well, a couple of ones I know act like drag queens. I don't know the big difference.
I think they think that a transsexual is the correct because...
Yeah, I know. Yeah. We have them in Provincetown, the heterosexual ones that look like, you know, they look like Mrs. Doubtfire, you know.
Holy ass. crap. My God, it's bigger than your God.
It's not that easy to
they don't tip
a woman
well
to look
either.
Like a woman.
That's another thing.
Yeah.
That the, ask anybody in Provincetown. They don't tip.
All right, stay right there. We'll be back with more from John Waters in a minute with some Twitter questions. I'm back talking with the fabulous John Waters. You know, I have some Facebook and Twitter questions for you, okay? Because people want to know about you.
Yeah.
First of all, well, we already did What's the Secret Behind the Mustache. We know what that is. Is there a fine line between good taste and bad taste?
I guess, but now everything's bad taste. I don't think anything in my book is in bad taste. I treat people with respect in the book.
You do. You do.
I look up to everybody I write about. I think reality TV a lot is bad taste when you make fun of the people in it and you feel superior to them. I don't feel superior to anybody in my book. They had more extreme lives than me.
Do you think it's bad taste to have a reality show about little people? You can't say midgets anymore. Little people.
Vertically challenged.
You think that's bad taste to show that? Because I've seen the show, and those people are happy with their lives.
I haven't seen the show. Is it bad to have one about tall people? I don't know. It seems to me everybody's a minority you can think of in some way.
From PR News in Washington, I'm not guilty of murdering a woman 20 years ago.
The U.S. military says more and more Iraqis exploded on time. The U.S. military pushing strollers down Baghdad's otherwise deserted streets. PR's bad.
French terrorism police contemplated what they'll do if there is a PR News.
Police spokesmen had been used in a number of armed robberies staged to raise money for Al-Qaeda's global jihad or holy questioning in Paris.
The chief labor negotiator for the Metropolitan Transportation Authority says this is PR News from Paris.
And yet, may we not still hope to discover a method by which, within one generation, the whole human race could be rendered intelligent beyond hatred or revenge or the desire for power? Is that not, after all, the ultimate goal of evolution?
Thank you.
won't you please come home? 'Cause your daddy's all alone. I have tried in vain, never no more to call your name. Now when you left, you broke my heart, but that will never make us part. For every hour in the day, you can hear me say, baby, won't you please come on home? Daddy needs loving. Baby, won't you please come home? Baby, won't you please come on home? Home. 'Cause your little daddy's all alone. Now I have tried in vain, never no more to call your name. Left you broke your daddy's heart, heart. But that will never make us part, never to make us part. For every hour in the day, yeah, you can hear your daddy say, won't you please come home, home, home.
If they're on it, it's their choice. It wasn't like they were kidnapped, of
That's
course,
true.
To be on the television show.
That's true. Okay, which Edna, this is a tough one for you. Which Edna Turnblad did you like better, Travolta or Divine?
Well, I liked them all because
or
they
Harvey
reinvented
Firestein.
It. They reinvented it. Divine played it realistically. Harvey played it like Broadway, Sing It Out, Louise.
Yeah.
And John Travolta played it like a Playboy bunny that got fat later in life.
Yeah, he did.
Well, but that happens. God
like a,
knows. It's like a muscle
girl.
Man that turns into a bear if they don't exercise.
But I enjoyed all three of them, too.
Yeah, me too.
I must
me
say,
too.
I like all of them. Let's see. Would you ever adapt Sarah Palin's Going Rogue into an epic miniseries?
No, but I'm more interested in Little Levi.
Why? What? tell me why.
Well, Levi, I know he's shown his penis. I'm wondering if he'll show other parts. You know, that's the real question that I need politically
to
know.
What else do you want to say?
Well,
what else is there? His armpit? What do you want to say?
Well, there's a few other areas that we haven't talked about that's been my specialty in Pink Flamingos.
Oh, my goodness.
There's this...
Thank you. Give me a little bit, put a bit, put a bit, put a bit in my mouth right now. Selling my birthright for corn and hay to feed my sacred cow. Selling my birthright in the long run, we'll all be dead anyhow. Give me a little bit, put a bit, put a bit in my mouth right now. I want a little bit, give me a little bit, put a bit, put a bit, put a bit in my mouth right now. I want a little bit, give me a little bit, put a bit, put a bit, put a bit in my mouth right now. Meanwhile, some saddle sore politicos are jockeying to grab the reins of power, sinking their spurs into your soft underbelly. You're queasy as your stomach begins to sour. You say, "Nay, that's not what I meant." You say, "Nay, that's not what I meant." You say, "Nay, that's not what I meant." You say, "Nay." Birthright for a bucket of oats, I'll be your thoroughbred. Selling my birthright, cram it down my throat, I'm a little overfed. Give me a little bit, put a bit, put a bit in my mouth right now. I want a little bit, give me a little bit, put a bit, put a bit, put a bit in my mouth right now. I want a little bit, give me a little bit, put a bit, put a bit, put a bit in my mouth right now. Meanwhile, some saddle sore politicos are jockeying to grab the reins of power, sinking their spurs into your soft underbelly. You're queasy as your stomach begins to sour. You say, "Nay, that's not what I meant." You say, "Nay, that's not what I meant." You say, "Nay, that's not what I meant." You say, "Nay."
You asked.
I know. You know, I'm just remaining, as my Aunt Rose would say, I'm remaining.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, what does John think of his early, really raunchy films now?
Well, I'm proud of them. They're like bad little children that still work. You know, I get older, my fans get younger. That's good, because they still are horrified by Pink Flamingos, and I think it will always work.
Yeah. Okay, John, it seems your works are more mainstream now than in the past. Is this because you've mellowed, or the world has become weirder?
Well, first of all, my last film, A Dirty Shame, got an NC-17. I had a lot of censorship hassles, so I don't know how much mainstream that is. I've written a book that talks about, you know, St. Catherine of Siena, a saint that drank pus and offered it up to God. I don't know how mainstream I am.
Did she really?
Yeah, she did, but maybe it worked.
Thank you. From PR News in Washington, I'm defending the left-wing former lawmaker eavesdropping on Mr. Bush today.
This program has targeted those with known links to Al-Qaeda, and I intend to kill American citizens.
The Democratic Senator Carl Levin of Michigan says bus drivers on some lines in New York City make a mockery of the U.S. Constitution's crucial system of checks and PR news. A new government report finds that illegal teenagers have declined in recent years, but killer prescription cigarettes will have lingering effects. On Wall Street, 10-846-724. Two large energy companies walked off the White House news conference today. Voters in Bolivia will be treated with medication to prevent PR news in Washington.
'Twas light in one October, I was feeling far from sober. I had in me and a bottle of joy and pride.
Joy and pride.
When me legs began to stutter, and I lie down in the gutter, and a pig came by and lie down by me side. I lie there in the gutter, thinking thoughts I cannot utter, when a lady passing by was heard to sigh.
You can tell a man who boozes by the company he chooses.
And the pig got up and slowly walked away.
You know, I'm going to try it later in life. Maybe it'll cure baldness.
You know what? I went out on a limb and said that they can't find these saints these days because they have medication now.
Yeah, that's true.
So and people saints, got mad at me for that. So they must get mad at you.
They never get mad at
me. Never get mad at
you. No, they don't.
Why? They don't really take you seriously.
No, they just think I'm so far gone. There's no point getting mad at me because I'm a happy neurotic.
You are a happy
neurotic.
And it's
hard to fight that.
And you wrote a really terrific book,
Thank you very much.
And you have
other
role models in here.
Oh, so I have everybody from Johnny Mathis. I have Bobby.
Johnny Mathis.
Yeah.
I love that you said about Johnny Mathis, that he doesn't force being a star.
He doesn't try too hard.
He's never
had a premiere. You ever interviewed him? Nobody's ever interviewed him.
No, not
and
since
he's still
Merv
famous.
Griffin.
Yeah, he still sells out every show, and he can sing great still.
Yes, okay. Thanks very much for joining me, John.
Thank you for having
the
me.
The book is called Role Models, and we liked it.
Thank you. Good night,
everybody.
Some of you have asked me to weigh in on the whole elevator gate thing, so here it is. You know, so many varsity and university level atheist pundits like me out there have shied away from this issue, but not me. You know, I used to puke like twice a day because of this illness, and I tell you, reading comments from you freaking junior varsity atheist boys on Facebook and Reddit, it's bringing all that stuff up again. It's a fucking sausage fest out there, and all you man boobs are acting like all the rest of the atheists will just nod and drool at your oh-so-unconcerned coolness and sexism. Anyway, someone's going to school ya. Now, Richard Dawkins is supposed to be fucking smart, and he is, he really is. So is Lala, but apparently he failed to learn from Lala. He fell into that really easy-ass trap of being a genius with a junior high school knowledge of human sexual interaction, like those young doctors you see on TV and, you know, like astronauts with crushes. So, you're a girl in your 20s. I'm talking to you guys, you teenage girls. I don't care who the man is. It's 4 in the morning. A guy in the elevator asks you to his room for coffee. What do? Do you go? The answer? No. You don't go. In the middle of the night, with a guy, for a first encounter, into a private room with him. But Hellbound Alleee, you say he's famous. I'm flattered. I want to meet him. He seems nice. He's got to be harmless. Fuck you. Do what I say. I don't care who asks you and when and what they ask you to do. You never go to a guy's place alone on a first date because that's stupid. This is basic 101 stuff, people, and I am speaking from experience. Males, shut up and listen. close your trap. I don't care if I'm painting you all with a broad brush. Some of us are smaller people. We have less body strength. We're working the odds and using something called common sense and knowledge that almost 100% of us are sexually assaulted before the age of 21. We can't get through college without getting fucking raped. Me included. Anyway, before I was imaginarily interrupted. This is what a smart, a not stupid guy does if he wants to actually get to know you. Doesn't matter if he wants to fuck you, he probably does, and that's fine, and this is the right way to do it. You meet for the first time, maybe the first couple of times, in public. Period. In a restaurant, in a bar, in a club, in a fucking lobby. Why the hell can't you chat over coffee in a fucking hotel lobby or bar? Why does it have to be a locked private room? Where is your famous brain, Dawkins? It makes you look like a creeper. Sure, even after you meet a couple times in public, you could still get burned. It happens all the time. That's called dating. But for fuck's sake, if you want to talk, talk. Don't do the spider and fly thing. It makes you look like a retard. And yes, Dawkins did own up to it. He did the whole free daycare thing at the convention, which is very, very cool. Does it end the whole rampant sexism in the internet atheist community thing? Hell no. Because this so-called atheist community on the internet happens to be a place for clueless teenagers and 20-somethings, and there are still way more males making open statements. Now, this is changing. I wish I could help better, but you know who's helping? These smart women on YouTube. They're making the biggest difference. This is what I want you ladies to remember. Kill your idols. Being a free thinker, this is what we want. Simply being an atheist is kind of irrelevant. It doesn't really tell us who you are. There are hundreds of kinds of atheists. Remember, there are still Raelians and white supremacists who are atheists. We're not all the same, and that's what we want. But free thinking, this is a good start to telling people who you actually are, what you actually believe in. And you can't very well think freely, can you, if you aren't able to question your heroes? No matter who they are, heroes are humans. There are no gods. We already know that. Humans can be very smart, even brilliant at some things, and maddeningly stupid at others. Pointing it out is not a betrayal to our community. That's called groupthink, not freethink. You can still admire whomever you want, but calling people on their bullshit is not treason. It's what friends do for friends. Call your friends out on their bullshit. It's for their own good. Even if they're boys who constitute the majority of these atheist movements. Majorities get pushy. That's the beast. Minorities can still be loud voices of reason. Remember, you can't be afraid to piss people off. You managed to reject religion, you got this far. Let's see how far your honesty can really go. See you next time.